learners, welcome to the class again. Today we are going to discuss about different tools and techniques. Under this, today we are going to discuss about observation and interview schedule. First, let us discuss about what is observation. In course of your teaching and doing other activities with children in your school, you might have experienced several peculiar natures of children which you do not get to know from any test. You might have observed how children behave in and out of classroom, how they interact with other children, their areas of interest, their likes and dislikes, other emotional states, and other such information, all of which can help you to assess the progress and hindrances in their learning in addition to the information from the test. Systematically observing students in natural setting, what we also call as the simulated setting, is a very useful technique for gathering data about students' performances in different curricular and co-curricular activities and about their effective behavior. Students' progress and behavior in areas like speaking, handwriting, singing, dancing, dramatization, punctuality, effective use of time, cordial relationship, giving respect to the elders cannot be evaluated through paper pencil test. This can be assessed only through observation techniques. An observational technique implies the use of a peculiar observational tool such as checklist, rating scale, or anecdotal records. According to Lehman, in the year 1999, the process of observing and recording an individual's behavior is what is meant by the term observational technique. You can observe your students from a very close quarter through participating or collaborating with them as their equal in their activities, especially in the participant observation, or you can observe them from a distance when they are busy in several activities, individually or in groups. Can be non-participant observation also. You can observe them in action directly when the students are aware of being observed, or directly when students are not aware of being observed. Observation can also be purposive, which is done intentionally with a definite plan, or it can be incidental also, which there is a chance of observation of peculiar behaviors. But frequent observation, either directly or indirectly, of students' work provides continuous feedback about the learning progress of the student. You can detect errors or problems in right times and take corrective measures to overcome them. Now let us look at some of the advantages of observation. If properly used, observation method has certain advantages. It provides a direct procedure for studying various aspects of human behavior, which may be the only effective way to gather data in a particular situation. It enables the observer to code and record behavior at the time of its occurrence. Observation has got certain limitations too. A subject may intentionally attempt to exhibit an artificial behavior when he knows that he is being observed. Observation method is time consuming and sometimes too very costly. Let me give you some suggestions regarding the observation tools. You can plan well in advance what to be observed and prepare an observational list. Do not take more behavior for a single observation. Take only one or two. Use clear and unambiguous terms in the observation tools. Carefully record and summarize the observation immediately, otherwise there is a chance of forgetting. Incidentally, when you observe some peculiar behavior, try to record it immediately and later on include it in your plan for further observation to check whether behavior was incidental or not. Learners, let us discuss something about interview schedule. Interview is an effective technique to collect information directly by face-to-face personal conversation with some specific purpose. When we need to find the reason for a particular behavior in the student, asking him or her personally is the best way to elicit the confidence which the student carry of his or her teacher will help the teacher in getting correct information. Depending upon the nature of the task, the interviewer can ask open-ended or close-ended questions to the students. The information received through the interview should be carefully recorded for arriving at a conclusion. Prior to the interview, the interviewer should prepare an interview schedule to record the information. The interview schedule helps the interviewer to focus on the points. Structured questions might simply the categorization and summarization of responses. They might also restrict what the subject is permitted to say. But on the other side, unstructured interview allows the respondent more freedom. Interviews are quite useful in questioning young children and illiterates. While interviewing a respondent, some precautions may be taken into consideration. Always ask such questions which will satisfy your purpose. Allow the time to the respondent to answer. Always try to build trust and confidence in the respondent. Make a rapport with the respondent. This will ensure stability of the interview. Always bring clarity in the questions. There are certain rules that should be followed during the conduct of interview to facilitate the data collection. These are: always ask only one question at a time. Do not overlap the questions. Always repeat a question whenever necessary. Always try to make sure that the subject understands the question. If the subject is unable to understand the question, always facilitate the question twice or thrice to the subject. Listen carefully to the subject's answer. Always observe the subject's facial expressions, gestures, and tone of voice. Allow the subject sufficient time to answer the question, but do not let the interview drag. Always avoid suggesting answers to the question. Do not show signs of surprise, shock, anger, or other emotions if unexpected answers are given. Always try to maintain a natural attitude with respect to controversial issues during the interview. Take note of answers that seem to be vague and ambiguous. The advantages of interview are to provide an opportunity to the interviewer to question thoroughly certain areas of inquiry. The interview permits greater depth of response, which is not possible through any other means. It also enables an interviewer to get information concerning feelings, attitudes, or emotions in relation to certain questions. There are limitations of interviews as well. The first limitation of interview is that it is a time-consuming technique. Interview always takes sufficient time to conduct. The effectiveness of the interview depends greatly upon the skill of the interviewer, not ordinarily possessed by the experienced researchers. There is a constant danger of subjectivity on the part of the interviewer. Moreover, even in the presence of the skilled interviewer, some interviewees will not respond freely, frankly, and accurately. So, dear learners, today I hope you have learned something on observation schedule and interview schedule with me. Thank you very much. See you in the other class.